Who buys photos? Who are the people that will fork out thousands of dollars without question? When I was starting out, like most of us, I thought that if I could get people who had heaps of money to come and see me, I'd get rich. Sounds fair enough, doesn't it? That's how you think it would work. So let me tell you this story. He arrived in a Lamborghini. She arrived in a Maserati, and each of the daughters arrived in a BMW. I almost fell over backwards when I saw that. I thought, oh my Lord, I've hit the big time. This is what I've been waiting for. All my Christmases have come at once. They were such a lovely family, and we had a great shoot, loads of laughter and genuine appreciation from them at the photo viewing. I was doing two appointments at the time, one for the shoot and another one for the viewing. I did the best edit I'd ever done, and I'm thinking $20,000 from this sale. And they loved the photos. They spent $800. I was astounded. I was thinking, you've got to be kidding. You turn up in $1 million worth of vehicles and you only spend $800? Big lesson learned, that one. There's a reason wealthy people are wealthy. They're cautious with their money. The wash up was that they asked me how long I kept the photos, as they wanted to come back and buy some more later on. You know, people have the best intentions, but a bird in the hand really is worth two in the bush. I never saw them again. I'm Mark Late, and I've got a lot of experience to share on what makes people tick. If you want to benefit from that experience, jump onto my YouTube channel and hit the subscribe button to stay in touch. Look, they were really lovely people. But again, time gets away and people move on to other things. You know who spends the money? It's the average people. It's the ones who live in the mortgage belt and have a 9-to-5 job. Marketing has changed, and whereas once we would promote our business at a shopping centre and catch the passers-by who were people that lived in that mortgage belt, nowadays we use Facebook because of its fantastic targeting ability and we reach the same audience. It's a bit different because with Facebook marketing you can be very specific about the kinds of people you want to reach. Shopping centres, they're more opportunistic. Everybody wants to win something, so your opportunity is there in either situation. They'll be walking past your display in a shopping centre and they'll think, why not, maybe I'll win something. And there's a good chance that they'll fill out an entry form. Facebook? Well, you can decide where you want your interest to come from. It's really very specific in it, and I think it gives you a competitive advantage over people who don't use this kind of marketing. We found that people in this category spend an average of $3,000, and that's all we want. We just want hundreds of them. There's plenty of stories around about photographers making $10,000 and $20,000 all the time, but I think they're just that. They're just stories. You do get them, but they're not as common as people make out. Aim for an average of $2,000 to $3,000 sales. There's more buyers around at that range than there is at the top end of town. As a matter of fact, you rarely see those top end of town people, but the average buyers are always there. And once you get enough of them, it's not hard to see the revenue stream increasing. If you'd rather listen than watch videos, go to the podcast page on our website. See you soon.